Good morning, dear students. In the previous class, we have studied about management and the definition of management. We explored what is management and we understood the definition of management. And in today's class, we are going to study the features of management. So there are so many features of management. What are the key factors or the features that we can say about the management? So that is what we are going to study in the today's class. So there are around 7 features are there for the management. And the first one is management is a goal-oriented process. Okay. So there is a goal, there is a purpose for every type of organization. So if an organization, see like if we are running a school, so there is a purpose of this school, isn't it? So we are providing better quality education is the main purpose of the school. So if we are running, so the this is the purpose of the school is that we have to provide a better quality education. So we need to update the facilities and we have to make proper good hygienic classrooms, and the teachers should be there, qualified teachers, and a better way, and even the language, we are giving more importance for the language. We give classes only in English medium, and we don't entertain any other languages. Okay, so such kind of system we are using. So we have some specific purpose or a goal is there. So all the activities that we are doing is based on this goal. So whatever may be the things that we are doing will be for the betterment of the school. So see, for example, in our school we are having like say if a lockdown situation is there. So in many schools they are not running online class or this type of things are not there. But we make online class and send it, and we found that there are different methods in that. So we tested with different methods and we found the best way of doing it. Okay, so we have to provide better quality education to the children. That is our goal, and for that we are entirely working for them. See, for example, if the purpose of an organization or a company may not be to make the it is not means better quality education or providing any good quality product may not be the main purpose of a company. A company's main purpose may be to earn maximum profit. Okay, so for that they will do whatever they can possible. So everything that that is possible, they will try to do. They will make a very powerful advertisements, and they try to attract the customers and try to increase their goal. So their different companies will have different, or different organizations will have different types of objectives or goals are there, and the purpose of the management is to achieve these goals. So achievement of this goal is the main effort of the management. If the management is successful, we can say that if a management is successful, then the objectives of the, or the goals of the organization has to be achieved. If a company is unable to achieve the organizational goals or the goals of the organization, then it simply means that the management is a failure. So it is the only depending on the work of the management, the success of this organization will be there. Okay. Then next topic that we have to study is that all pervasive. So all pervasive means that, pervasive means that applicable in all the situations. Okay, so you can say that anything minus management is equal to zero. Means for everything management is required. See, for example, if we are in the school, so for running a school there is management required. So we have a manager and we have proper management system, and we manage the things. So it's like if, for example, the classroom is there or this online class is there, so it has to be managed properly. Otherwise, see like if some teachers are entering some classes there and some are sending in WhatsApp, some are sending in YouTube. So if any systematic way of approaching is not there, then it will be very much difficult to handle. Okay, so proper management is required in that. So if it is a hospital, there is also requirement of a proper management is there. Even in our house, in our home also, management is required. See, like if your father is earning money and your mother has to be handled the activities which are to be held in your home. Okay, so see, like your father has to calculate how much amount of fund is there, and he has to make a budget for the month, and he has to spend the money, and he has to calculate how much money is required for food, how much money is required for other activities, how much is required for the education of the children. So different type of purposes are there, and for that they have to allocate different fund, and how to get this money, and how to manage this money, and how to make savings, or all these type of things they have to handle. So for that better way of management is required. Okay, so in everything management is required. That is why the management is known as all pervasive. Okay, The next feature of management is called a management is a multi-dimensional. So there are different dimensions. So dimensions means the perspectives that we look at the things. So there are the management is a multi-dimensional. It has got different dimensions. So there are two, three dimensions. The first one is about management of a work. So there are so many works that have to be performed. So different type of activities are there, different works are there. So these works has to be managed. The first management is done on the work. There are so many works, so many activities have to be performed, and these activities have to be properly managed. Second is about the management of people. So management of people means that there are so many employees, so many people are there in the organization, and they have to be managed. So some people are self-motivated, they do their work by themselves. But some people are not motivated at all. They are not having any interest to do the job. So they have to be motivated, they have to be given incentives, or sometimes they have to be given punishment, motivation, all these type of things are required for making the people to work. So that, and they should also, the work that they are doing should be directed towards the achievement of the organizational goals. So these type of things are to be there. And the next management is about the operations. There are different kinds of operations or functions are there. So different operations are there, like a sale is there, purchase is there, production is there. So many activities are there to be performed in the organization. So many operations are there. And these operations have to be properly managed. So if, see, like if in an organization, if the how much amount of purchase is there, based on that the production should be there. So there should be a coordination between the production and the purchase. And there should be also a production and the sale should have also a coordination. So this coordination has to be managed. Then only the organization can be going in a successful way. Okay. Then next one is called as a continuous process. Management is a continuous process. So we cannot say that, see, like once I manage the things and after that it is over. Once a plan is made, it is implemented, work is over. Not like that. Okay, management is a continuous process. See, like if a school. So imagine that, like if for this year we have made a plan and we thought of doing it, like online class is there. So we start an online class and we start doing this one. So it went on. It will not go smoothly like that. Yes, you know. So we will find that, see, like when you start online classes, there will be some kind of issues are there. So last year we had 2-3 types of online class we have tried. First we tried with the TeachNext, and we were trying to do all live classes, but we were facing so much amount of struggles because in different areas people are having low network and the students are unable to attend the class. So they have to come on live, and they were coming and it was getting disconnected and all these type of problems. So there was a very big issue like that. Then after that we dropped that. Then after that we started uploading classes through WhatsApp. So then in WhatsApp also there was a big problem is that, see, like the videos that we are making is of very high size, very big size of videos are there. And we are unable to send these videos to the students. And the students also, if we have to watch a video in Facebook, first we have to download this video fully. So what happens is that, see, like if one student is getting plenty of videos and if it is getting downloaded, it requires a huge amount of memory. And it requires the data also, so you use a lot large amount of data will be spent, and you need to save these videos in your phone itself, so it requires large amount of storage, so it will create lot amount of problems. So that again problem must be. So then we found another method of called like Google Classroom. So we started, so in that the video will be directly uploaded to the Google Classroom and you will be able to watch the videos. But it was also finding so much difficulty. After that we created our own website, and after that we started uploading videos into the website. But in website also there was some kind of issues. So this year we have again we made new website, and in that we have, so we have made some modifications to the website. So we have to do whatever plans that we are making, it has to be go on changing. So continuous process it is will be required. Again and again we need to change one plan we will make, we will implement the plan, we will find that this is not working, or if there are some problem, then again we have to overcome this problem. So again we have to make another plans. So this work will go on like that. So this it is a continuous process. We cannot stop complete management and sit there, not like that. So means always we need to do this one. So that is the then it is a group activity. If only one person is there, there is no need of management. So if I am doing everything by myself, then I don't need to be managed. So if only one person is there, there is no need of any management. When many people are doing together, when group of people are there. See, like in our classroom, when we are having plenty of students and there are so many teachers are there, so different students are there of different attitude, different mentality, different way of behaviors are there. So we need to do group activity. We have to make them into different kind of activities has to be there. So that is why group activity. So management is a group activity. Then it is a dynamic function. So as it is there, as I told you, like changes are required. It will be always moving. The business environment is entirely changing always. Okay. So if, as I told you, like we are facing the coronavirus pandemic situations, and there are like we have made a plan. So last year we like we were planning to do planning to go home, and by the time it was kept lockdown and we were unable to go. And this year also we thought that we will be able to go. Now again the coronavirus cases are increasing and we don't know whether we will be able to go there, whether schools and even the exams are there. So you have already heard that the exams have been postponed. So for class 12th and class 10 exam is cancelled. So we were preparing, some students were preparing for the exams, and they are now they are saying that the exam is cancelled. Earlier CBC was telling that we will anyhow conduct the exam, but now they are saying that we will not conduct the exam. So these type of changes are there. So and according to the changes, we have to make changes to ourselves also. Or the companies also, they have to prepare for these changes. So business environment is entirely changing. Always there will be a lot amount of changes like that, and we have to change according to the these situations. Then the last function or last feature of management is called intangible force. Intangible means which we cannot see. Okay, so that we cannot see, like with management, like imagine that, like if little flower school, if you consider, there is a management, but you cannot see what is a management there, or you cannot see that there is a management, but you can see that the impact of management there, isn't it? So when you come to the school, you will see that the school is properly organized, there are a proper system, there is like classrooms are there, so you are going and sitting in the classroom, all the things are properly arranged, it shows that there is a proper management there. Okay, and if you go to the school and you will find that the school children are working some side, one side, teachers are in another side, and the classrooms and all are not properly arranged, and the things are not in a proper order. So you understand that there is no proper management there. So you cannot see what is management, but the impact of management can be visible, or the effect of management can be seen. So if a company is successful, it means that a company is managed properly. Or if a school is going in a successful manner, it shows that there is a proper management. So any kind of any function, or if a hospital, or any even if it is a shop, so if you go to a shop itself, you will find that, see, like if plenty of things are there, if you go, there are markets are there, and in that there are so many shops are there. When you go to some shops, there is products and all are systematically arranged, properly kept there, there are so many employees are there, and they will do the work, and as and when the customer comes, they will try to find out or try to solve the problems of the customer. So then that kind of management is there. So proper management of things are there. So that things will go on smoothly. Okay. So that is about the features of management. So we have, so far we have studied about the different features of management. Okay. Thank you so much.